I've set out to make a video which goes through the top 10 explainer videos, but the video is so long I've split it into two parts. So in this video we're going to see entries 10 to 6, and in the next video I'm going to be doing entries 5 to 1. There are a few subscription based softwares in here, but where possible I've tried to do one time fee only.
To get the best video footage, set your shutter speed to 150 and use the lowest ISO value that gives a correct exposure.
So that video was made with Animation Studio, and Animation Studio you can buy for $47 one off, but there's a voucher up here for $10 off, so we're going to call it $37. It's not the best, it's not the most user friendly, and I'm going to show you why. Let's dive into it. So I'm in Animation Studio and it's got a very simple interface. So I'm going to go to here, and these are our scenes and our assets. Now you can't search them, that's annoying. You've got to click into them and see what they've got. So this person's got a checkboard, so if I click on him, I bring him into the scene. I can position him and I can flip him or rotate him, and I can make him bigger or smaller. Let's put him back that way, so I can make him bigger or smaller. It feels like it's designed for your children. So let's put him there. Now, he's going to be there for the whole thing, and we might not want that. So we use this slider to specify his duration. So I'm going to put him at the end of the video. I'm going to put him here, 6.5 seconds. And if we want him to transition in, we move this out, and then we double click on this, and we pick our transition. So squashing, getting bigger, fading in. Let's have him zoom in like that. It's probably better from the other side, actually. And we click apply. So I'm going to show you text as well. So we go here for text and we can type in our text and we can add it. So this is a man. Let's add this text and it goes here. It looks very basic. We can then make it text to speech. So if I click enable for text to speech, then this text is read out. Now, I did a voiceover using text-to-speech, and actually, I made it down here. So I put my whole video narration in here, and I set it to 2 and shoved it down the corner so that no one had noticed, and I clicked Enable Text-to-Speech with Matthew. I also could have made the text white so that it wouldn't be visible, but that doesn't feel like a great thing to do. If we go here, we can add audio, we can add music, and we can record voiceover, and we can add voiceovers as well. Here we can add a watermark. This button we can use to import images. We've talked about text. We've talked about the graphics. Again, you can't search for them. It's a bit annoying. If you go here, you can pick on already made scenes. But I don't know why you'd want to do that unless they exactly fitted what you were trying to make, and they won't fit. So you save your project and you go to export. Now the exporting is a bit weird. I'm going to export in 1080. I think I've had an upgrade to export in 1080. So here we go. You have to sit and wait. Now it says it's safe to change tabs now. And if you change tabs, it takes ages. So you've got to sit there and wait. Stay in your tab. Don't move to another tab or go off and check your emails or anything, because it will cause a problem. And then it says ready to download. So it does take a while. And it says video is ready, so if I click here, I can download the video. That is Animation Studio.
Get pro looking footage easily. To get pro footage, follow these easy steps. Set your shutter speed to 1/50 and use the lowest ISO value that gives a correct exposure.
So let's take a look at RenderForce, and we're going to start by looking at the prices. So what's great is you can have a free account and there aren't really any restrictions on that. You can get started, you can see whether you like it. If you want to upgrade, it's going to be between £12 and £19 a month. You're probably not going to go for the business account at £25. So let's see how to make an explainer video in RenderForest. So in RenderForest, we can make lots of videos, but really the explainer ones are here towards the top. We've got 3D explainer, trendy explainer, whiteboard explainer, and we've got a sort of explainer toolkit. I made my short video using the Trendy explainer toolkit. So let's have a look at this one. So we get a video that sort of previews it. We get some other things down here, some other previews, but essentially we just click create now. And once we go into this screen, we have templates as well. It's always best to make your own. So I'm going to click on start from scratch. Now here we've got the type of scene we can have, and it's quite easy to navigate because we might have maps. We've got some maps. We might have check marks, which is sort of lists of things. We might have things for testimonials. Most likely you're going to quite like kinetic typography, logo animation, and characters. So if we look at corporate female characters, they're doing certain things. So I'm back in my project and you can see I've got these three scenes here. If we want to add another scene, we just click here and we end up in this menu where we can filter and then pick the right scene. I'm not going to add another scene. So on this first slide, I just gave it a title. That's all I did. I picked a title one and I just typed in a title. Here, because I was filming and it's about filming, the closest thing I could get is someone doing a selfie. So I put to get the best footage. Now you'll notice here we've got scene duration, a minimum and a maximum, and you can change your scene duration. That's quite important. You don't want things in your explainer videos to be too long, and I'm going to talk about that very soon. In this scene, I found a picture and I click here, and if I click replace image, we can see I can upload, I can go to my files, I can go to stock images, or I can use an image URL. I clicked on stock image and I can do a manual searching with the stock images they have access to. I'm not going to replace this, so I'm going to cancel. And I just put in, for the best video, set your shutter speed to 1/50, use a low ISO value. That's not what you hear in the video because these text inputs have character limits. So what I wanted to put in here, I couldn't fit in, so I had to shorten it. Next, we go to style and we can pick different styles. I went with the default. We go to music and you can add music, but also you can add a voiceover. So I recorded for each scene a voiceover, and actually I didn't record it. I thought about recording it and then I went for text to speech because I knew that would sync better. So I can record a voiceover through the website for each scene, but I went for text to speech and I just typed my text to speech in. The audio at the end gets cut off, so I'm just going to lengthen that. And again, that's lengthened my scene duration. So remember I said scene duration is important. If we go here, we can see the text to speech or the voiceover is only a couple of seconds and the scene is 5 seconds. So this originally started off there, but I put it in the middle to bulk the scene out. You don't want to have your speech said and then have to wait around for a couple of seconds. That doesn't flow very well, so put it in the middle. Sadly, this scene has a minimum of 5 seconds. Either I fill it with additional narration or I just have a bit of silence. And then when we go to preview, we can do a fast preview or you can export to 1080p or 720. That's because of the package I'm on. Again, we talked about packages at the start of this. So I'm in Widio and we're going to look at the pricing. You get a free account and that doesn't cost you anything, but you can't download your videos. And we're going to look at the free account in a moment. And then the next package up is $19 per month. And that is billed annually. And you only get 10 downloads per month and videos are 1.5 minutes long. So let's look at the video editor. So here is my video and I'm just going to play it through here because I can't download it. Here we go.
To get the best video footage, set your shutter speed to 1/50 and use the lowest ISO value that gives a correct exposure.
So if we go up here, we've got our images and we can go into stock, but really we're going to want to use these explainer things. So we've got infographics, sketch. You find a lot of them are the same, but just in different styles. I picked animated. So if we look in animated, we have these animated characters, and I felt the best one for me was to go down here and find this chat with a mobile phone here. Again, it's really difficult to find stuff for video. So I put him in and he appears like that, but I'm going to now delete him. When we click on an asset, and it's probably best to show this with text, we have an in and an out. So we can set the transition in. I liked hands, so I picked hands, and we can set the transition out. Down here on this bar, we can adjust where things happen. Now, the one strength Widio has is keyframing. For this text, when I put it in, I added a keyframe and set it small. And then I added another keyframe halfway through and I made it bigger. So I repositioned it and I extended it and scaled it and made it bigger. What I don't like is I can add text, but I can't add any shapes with it. So that's a little bit annoying. There's some things down here, interactivity, which requires an upgrade, adjustments, it just seems to be opacity. You can also add in video. Again, it's mainly stock video or uploading your own. You can insert a background. There are some nice backgrounds. I used this background. Inserting sound. So what we can do is we can do text-to-speech, which I did. So I put my text-to-speech in. I previewed it. You then have to download it and then re-upload it. So it appeared in my audio. Background music we can put in. Down here is each element. Bit here is my man. Here is my first text. Here's my second text. This is my corporate music, and I've dropped the volume down. And this is my text to speech. If you need keyframing or repositioning and you want a web-based application, then this is it. To get the best video footage, set your shutter speed to 1/50th of a second and use the lowest ISO possible that gives you the correct exposure. So this is Mega Video Robot. It says Animator, but Mega Video Robot is the newer version and you can buy it for $30. Now I have Animator and it's exactly the same. I think Mega Video Robot you can do 4K, but this is exactly the same. I reviewed both of them and I'm going to be using this to talk about Mega Video Robot. So it's quite good. I'm using this on a PC. It's not a web-based app, but it is really quite good. So I'm going to add a slide here and it automatically picks your slide. Now the slide sort of comes from the theme and we've got different themes here. I went for this Sunray theme, but you've got all these other themes. You've got 5 built-in themes. We can add in text and we type it out here. This is text. We can change its size. If we click highlight, it puts a box around it. So we might want to have a yellow box. This is going to look absolutely horrible. An effect. Yeah, so that's it with the highlight. So I'm going to double click on it. I've also made a spelling mistake and I'm going to take that text highlight off. So we can pick how it appears. And I'm going to, for the other ones, I picked fly in and I'm going to just do right to left. I've given it a shadow. We can also set the disappearance and I'm just going to have fly out. And I'm going to have it left to right and I'm going to click OK. So now we've got this on our slide. We can extend how long it's visible on the slide and we can change the in and out down here. That's going to come in and then it's going to fade out. And I might just want to... So if we go to images, we have to click add image and there's lots of images that come with it. Now we've got characters. It's annoying. You can't search them and it does take some time for the assets to sort of load. So I quite liked, and again you end up going past them, I liked this calling man, so I'm going to add him. And again we can set how it comes in, appear. I'm just going to pick random and I'm going to click OK. So we've got that. Now I'm going to want to adjust this so that the text comes in first. Text comes in first and then this man. I'm going to put him over here, make him a little bit smaller, like so. To add a transition between the slides, we just go to transition and we pick a transition, move left, and it applies it here. So we can add sounds in. So if we want to add in sound effects, we can add them here. We select it and we press add. We can preview it as well. If we want to add in background music, we click here and we can pick our background music. Easy. I'm not going to add any music this time. We can also do some looping if we want to. If we want to add video, we have to upload ours. It doesn't come with any video. And then if we want to add a voiceover, we click on voiceover and it will do a voiceover for the whole thing. So we want to record voice and I'm going to click record and I just talk away. And what I can do is I can go to the next slide, set your shutter speed to 1/50th of a second and use the lowest ISO possible. And I click stop. And when I click OK, it's going to add it down the bottom and it adjusts things accordingly, which is really useful. When you record your voiceover, that's it. You've got one go. You can stop and pause and you can move slides and that's it. It puts it in and then we click on produce and we can do it as full HD and we can pick the quality and it renders quite quickly. So if you could only afford one piece of software and you can only afford $30, this is quite a comprehensive piece of software.
Pro Filming. To get the best video footage, set your shutter speed to 150 and use the lowest ISO value that gives the correct exposure.
So we're in Pictory AI, and Pictory AI starts at $19 per month. You get a free trial where you can make 3 videos up to 10 minutes long, so you can see if you like it. So Pictory AI is text to video, but it's really quite good. So I'm going to look at script to video. There are these other things you can do, but script to video is the main thing. So I'm going to look at that. So I'm going to give it a name, and it's going to be shutter speed. That's what I'm calling all these things. And I'm just going to paste it in, and I click proceed, and I can pick from a template. I can make my own templates, and the templates really are how the text comes in. I quite like this. So Pictory AI is really pictures and text. What's nice is we can pick our aspect ratio. That's the first one that we can pick our aspect ratio in this so far. Now it uses AI, and sometimes I'll get it right and sometimes I'll get it wrong. Sometimes the nuance might be off. This, not very good. So I'm going to go to visuals, and I'm going to search, and I'm just going to search for filming. The stock footage is from Storyblocks, so you're going to get very good stock footage. So I'm going to pick this one. Next one, I could have exactly the same stock footage, or I could have different stock footage. Talking about ISO, so I'm going to pick this one here, and I'm going to go to audio now. So I can apply background music, and that came in with my template. So shake up has been applied. I'm going to go to voiceover, and I'm going to do text to speech. I'm just going to pick Joey. I'm going to just check audio settings to make sure my background music is low, and it is. And I'm going to click generate, and that's it. That's all you have to do. It's really quite easy. You can change your styles. You can set up your own branding, and you can change the format. Don't forget, I've split this video in two, and when the next video is ready, you'll be able to see it here.